Emily Dozier, senior planner with the Dutchess County Planning Department, says they just finished a countywide bicycle pedestrian plan. It's supporting bicycling as transportation. But before it's implemented, the county wants to make sure bicyclists get the skills necessary in order to ride in the trails as well as on the roads. About a dozen residents took part in Basic Traffic Skills for Bicycles, a collaboration with the New York State Bicycling Coalition and the Dutchess County Transportation Department.
Bicycling is becoming more and more popular both across the country but also here in Dutchess County, and we're seeing new facilities like the Sharrows and Beacon and Pauling and Amenia, and all the rail trails, of course, that people love so much. So yeah, I think it's really exciting. It's a great time to support this movement of safe and healthy transportation.
Bill Barber, a licensed cycling instructor with the League of American Bicycles, says most of us know how to ride a bike, but many don't have the skills and confidence it takes to ride along with traffic.
The motorists and the cyclists need to be aware of each other because the exact same rules apply in most every case to both. With the proliferation of the biking infrastructure and fitness culture and so forth, bikes are just flying off the shelves of the shops, and more people are taking to their bikes at all ages.
And with Governor Cuomo's recent $10 million in funding towards biking projects right here in the Hudson Valley, we'll not only see more and more cyclists on our rail trails, but we'll also see more on our roadways. So all the more reason to learn the rules of the road.
Cyclists fare better when they act and behave as operators of motor vehicles. So in other words, if you're operating and driving your bike, now you don't have a gas pedal necessarily and your body's the engine, and there's some significant differences like that, but the way you blend into traffic and how you signal your intentions, communicate with the other vehicles out there, whether they're other cyclists or other cars. But if you're behaving as a vehicle, you're going to tend to fare better. Statistics bear out that you're, you know, going to be, you know, far less subject to any sort of crash or some injury.
I really wanted to just learn what the real rules are of the road for a cyclist and be able to do it safely and make sure that everybody's safe out there on the road, whether you're a motorist or a cyclist, and we can share the road together.
Skip Weissman, who's been riding since he was a kid, says he recently took up cycling as a form of transportation.
When you're riding around in a neighborhood, it's a lot different than, you know, you're riding out on the road with cars around and there being traffic lights and signals and all that stuff. Boil it down to one thing, it's about awareness. As a bicyclist out there with motor vehicles and other things, and pedestrians as well, you have to just have a really great awareness of your surroundings.
And we hope that from this class they'll go on and be some examples, good examples, and maybe some ambassadors, encourage other people to take up the same type of training.